Much of how we view life in the universe, the Fermi paradox, and SETI in general, rests on an assumption. That assumption is simple, that biological intelligence is the end game for a species. They reach it, become a civilization, and then develop technology, and eventually we come into contact with them. Seems straightforward, and would yield a Star Trek-like universe full of biological species. But that thinking has an Achilles heel, one that we ourselves, as an advancing civilization, may indicate. There may be a flaw in the reasoning that biological intelligence is an endgame. It may instead be that advanced alien civilizations shun biology entirely and become technological in nature, and may end up having no interest in communicating with primitive biological civilizations such as ourselves. At the heart of this idea is a paper authored by Stephen Dick in 2006, link in the description below, where he details that SETI does not take a certain aspect of our civilization well into account when formulating what they search for. This aspect is cultural evolution, the phenomenon that our civilization has and will continue to try to increase our knowledge and even our intelligence. Eventually, we will begin to enhance our intelligence with technology. It's at that point that we become post-biological. Assuming that all civilizations do that, and they would have to if they were to become advanced civilizations at all, then the end result of a civilization is to become based on technology and artificial intelligence rather than more limited biological intelligence. This has profound implications on life in the universe in that most of it may not be biological at all. We are on the cusp of beginning that technological transition, but it can be easily argued that civilizations far older than our own are fully within the realm of possibility, by billions of years in fact. Those civilizations may have given up their biology long ago, and may present a completely different paradigm for what intelligence is and where it might exist. One aspect of this is environmental tolerance. Machines have a completely different set of needs than biologicals do. For example, they can function in deep space without the need for oxygen. This means that they may not need planets at all, and in fact could exist in deep space. As it stands, SETI tends to look for planets as targets, preferably Earth-like. But post-biological intelligences could be anywhere. Another aspect of this, which gets into the zoo hypothesis, see my video on this channel about that, is that if a culture advances always seeking knowledge and increasing its intelligence, why would they want to communicate with a civilization like ourselves that are not as far along? That in itself is one of the major solutions to the Fermi paradox, or they may simply wait to hear from us, or wait until we become post-biological before initiating contact. But there is another possibility, that it may not be possible to communicate with such a civilization at all. This is usually called the incommensurability problem and boils down to a simple thought. A civilization so advanced and so post-biological may think and communicate so differently that we won't comprehend it or even recognize it when we see it. Food for thought. Thanks for listening. I am futurist and science fiction author John Michael Godier, and while it's not enough for an update video yet, KIC 8462852 as of June 16th is dipping again at about 2% last I heard. More on that as information comes out, and be sure to check out my books at your favorite online book retailer and subscribe to my channel for regular in-depth explorations into the interesting, weird, and unknown aspects of this amazing universe in which we live.